Anatoly Zverev was a famous Russian artist. The AZA Musée in Moscow is named after his name and displayed his art. There are numerous books and films about his work and life. These records, the facts of his biography and the testimony of his contemporaries speaks of his incredible abilities and the strange way of his life. Unquestionably, it was God's gift, but also the outcome of the events he has lived through. There is one story that a few remember or that most never know. In my view, it explains the Zverev phenomenon better than anything else. Anatoly was born in Moscow. During the World War II, his family, father, mother, the 12 years old boy and two sisters found themselves in the village in the Tambov region, south of Moscow, behind enemy lines and not far from the fighting. The partisans were attacking the Germans. The Germans responded and executed those they managed to manage. The remnants of partisan unit went hidden into the woods, so the Germans retaliated against the locals and eradicated all villages. Once the house where the Zverevs have been staying was hit by an artillery round. The mother was at work, the kids were playing outside, the father was sick and in a bed inside the house. Suddenly everything changed. The house was destroyed, the father's legs were blown off. This was absurd and paradoxical. Anatoly survived but experienced a strong shock which deeply scared him psychologically for the rest of his life. This explains the algorithm of his art and determines the fairy nature of his work, the lighting assessment of the situation, the explosion reaction, and the victorious signature of the survivor. His impressions were on the tip of his fingers. The bunch of brushes painted the hieroglyphs of what he has seen. He improvised and worked it using anything on everything. The media didn't matter, and nor did the result. The disciplined and the copyist and the other practitioners of the unchained manner of his painting could never master either the psychological intensity or the impressiveness of his striking, sometimes visionary images. His work, however, were not always masterpieces. After the war, the family returned to Moscow also for a period of time, living in the district of Sokolniki. It seems that the horrors of war were over. Anatoly kicked the soccer ball with other boys, played checkers in the park, and did a lot of drawing. His grades in school were mediocre. He eventually entered the trade school to become a fresco painter and for a short time studied in the year of 1905 art college, but was expelled for bad behavior. His formal education was over, but the interesting part of his life was just the beginning. Meeting people. His horizons were greatly expanded, but Sinitsyn, Rumnev, and especially by Kostakis and his collection of the art 1910s, 1920s avant-garde art. By living through books kept in their houses and looking at the reproductions, he learned about the old masters and the first wave of Russian avant-garde. The forbidden art that was neither mentioned in lectures or displayed in museum. These mentors not only enriched his inner world, but also appreciated his talent. Zverev was strongly attached to them. Anatoly was simple and friendly, but somewhat on guard with others. He felt safe among people. The Sokolniki Park and the City Committee of Graphic Artists on Malaya Gruzinska Street and other places in central Moscow were crowded. They were very different from his parent place in the city, Boondocks in the Sviblovo district. That area reeked the potential danger. He hated living there and called it Dumlovo. He wandered around the city, sleeping on a couch in friend's apartment and paying for a lodging with a portrait of his hosts. His affair with old woman Oksana Asieva looked absurd. She was 39 years his senior, but it went on for many years. The rumor mill called Oksana the Kremlin Wall, but the truth was that Zverev was romantic. Unknown to anyone and unkempt, he wanted to win over a great beauty and heroine of the 1920s poetry, who was rising on porch Gorky Street, Moscow's main thoroughfare. He wished to push from her heart and house the ghost of her late husband, a famous poet well treated by the state. He wanted to show what he is capable of and win all battles at once. He immediately recognized in the aging lady the image of remaining beauty, regardless of her actual years, immortalized her on canvas, paper, and in verse. The muse of the poets became his muse too. Zverev, the survivor, became the legend of the second wave of Russian avant-garde art. That's it. Thank you.